Okay, so welcome to Yoga with Smiles, and it's a pleasure to bring this class from Vrindavan Yoga and Smile Makers Trainings. We are doing it every day of the week. It's a wonderful service and we are happy to see more and more participation from all of you all. So as usual in the beginning, I will give you quick tips on some soft skill topic, okay? So all of you all have gone to literal formal education, to school and college. And why do we go there? Because we want to build up our intelligence, okay? Most of the time in school, what they do is they check your IQ. You must have done some intelligent quotient tests and check, oh, this one is very intelligent, that one is very intelligent. But tell me something, suppose sometimes you go for your school reunion. You know, the most intelligent people, do they really perform very, very well in life? Think about it. Someone who is considered really intelligent, when you actually see them later in life, no, Mallika shaking her head. Yeah, because there is no connection, not much connection between the intelligent quotient and the actual performance in life. Okay, so what is required for you to perform well in life? Along with IQ, nowadays most companies, they don't just check the IQ of new recruits. They also check something else. Anyone has an idea? Suppose you're going for an interview for a really big company. They don't just check your IQ.
Emotional.
Say it loudly.
Emotional quotient.
EQ, yes. The emotional quotient. So any idea what is emotional quotient? So quick tips I will give you.
Okay.
Yeah, please tell me. What do you think is emotional quotient?
How well you can get along with others.
Yes. So whether we like it or not, our emotions play a very important role in our lives. Okay? And many times we are the receiving end of emotions and emotions take over our behavior. But there is an aspect to it. If you're able to be in control of your emotions. So what is emotional quotient? Emotional quotient is simply, it covers three things. One is, now I want you to ask yourself these questions. Are you aware at any given time what is the emotion that you're going through? So the first aspect of emotional quotient is your self-awareness. Okay? You yourself being aware of your emotions. The second aspect of emotional quotient is you managing your own emotions, self-management. Are you able to manage your emotions such that you are able to be in control of your emotions and you don't allow your emotions to direct? Many times, think about it, any decision you take when you're highly emotional may not be the right decision. What is required is for you to be calm and cool and then take a decision. So, are you in a position to manage your emotions? Because there is a connection between your emotions and your actions. Okay? Now, we are humans most of the time. At least me personally, I feel in the morning, I am very much in control of my emotions. I am calm and composed and, you know. But by the time it becomes evening, I tend to get irritated for small things. So, generally, what I do is that I do not take any decision, or if I have to do an important work or if I have to think something, I do all that in the morning because I feel I'm in a better frame of mind in the morning. Suppose I try something with technology and the computer acts funny and I get so flustered and I'm not able to work on the computer after that. So I prefer doing such difficult jobs in the morning when I feel I'm more in control of my emotions. Okay? There's another aspect of emotions. Okay, one is self-emotional awareness and self-emotional management. And there are two more aspects is being aware of the emotions of the people around you. Many times we are not even aware. somebody is angry, somebody is irritated, somebody is upset, somebody is just come home after a tiring day at work, and then we go on and on and on with our complaints. Okay, so what is required is you also being aware of what is the emotions that other people are going through. Okay, there is a word for this. Anybody knows what's the word for this? Feeling what the other person is feeling. Empathy, yes. Empathy, you know. So, one of the things which we really need to practice, especially when you're dealing with people, is check whether you are aware of what is the emotion of that other person. You know, see, so many times I remember my mother, every day she would call me and she would ask me, what did you eat? What did you eat? What did you eat? And I would think like, why is she asking me every day? Chaitra, you're not married. Correct? Your mother calls you and asks you? Yeah? Yeah? Yeah. And then you wonder.
Yeah, she always calls me and asks.
Yeah. So we wonder why. Why is she every day asking? You know, the same story again and again. But can you get what is the emotion behind that question? Can you get what is the emotion, Chaitra?
Caring.
You know, she cares for your health. She wants to check whether is my Chaitra eating good food or not. Is she healthy, eating healthy? It's a care. If you can get her care behind a repeated question, then you will not get irritated by answering that same question again and again. Do you realize? This is just a small example to show how we have to be also aware of other person's emotion. Okay? And when we are aware of the other person's emotion, the fourth aspect is social management. So one is self-emotion management and one is social event. Then accordingly, you will change your behavior because you're aware of the other person's emotions. Do you get that? So this is what, in brief, emotional intelligence is about. Okay? So that's a small takeaway. Go back today and think how emotional you are. Okay, there was a time when you know, with age, we tend to mellow down. Okay? So there was a time when we were younger when we would just get highly emotional for everything. You know, anybody says something, we really want to react. And in the long run, you think it's not worth it. Is it worth? Okay? That is why when an auto rickshaw driver shouts at us or talks rudely, you know, now I realize there's no point. We don't bother. Why should I break my emotions and why should I get emotionally upset because of some rickshaw driver talking rudely to me? Okay, there was a time I would get very upset and flustered and I would go and I would complain and I would do all sorts of things. And in the long run, I really think it is not worth it that I should, you know, break my emotions and get flustered for the sake of unnecessary things. So did you all get the four aspects of emotional intelligence? And there are a lot of, I have so many questionnaires. I have a whole lot of, because I'm doing a full workshop on this. So, you know, there are a lot, if you go online, you will get a lot of, just like you have IQ tests, you have EQ tests also. So you can, I suggest you just go there and do your EQ tests and check what is your level of emotional intelligence. Okay? That is self-emotion, self-management, self-awareness, self-management, social awareness, social management. Simple? Four simple points. Got it? Yeah? Okay? So have a nice, happy, emotional time with yourself and with all the people around you. Okay? How are you feeling right now? All of you? When somebody asks you how you feel, what do you say? Fine. Most of the time, we only say fine. But look at all the emoticons on your mobile. There are 101 emoticons, but we always say fine. Okay? Chalo, feel fine. Have a great day. Bye.